outside on my back patio, have to record out here today because I have guys upstairs working on renovating our upstairs area where my studio is. So I literally can't be inside because it is it's insanely loud hammering, and they're demolishing today. Demolition, whatever. You get my point. I have trouble with that word. Okay. Hey, this is real life. This is what's going on. Crypto prices are going down. Why are they going down? What's going on? Is this kind of continuing that narrative of effectively kind of a move down, a free fall, if you will, a plummeting scenario? No, I don't think so. I'm going to show you exactly. See, I can't even talk right now. I'm going to show you what is going on. But I will tell you this before we get into this. Here's what it comes down to. I think we have a little bit of rough waters ahead of us. I think we'll continue to see that in the summer. Summers historically in crypto are not great times. There's that saying, make money in May and go away. Although May has not been great to make money, quite frankly, outside of the meme coin frenzy that has been going on, which, by the way, has chilled a little bit as well. Okay, so let's take a look at what is going on. Here, really, in my opinion, is the main story. You've got the Dow 30 down 219 points. Retail sales missed estimates. Home Depot causing a year of, saying it's going to be a year of moderation. You've got kind of a bad scenario playing out in the mainstream media about more hardship coming, if you will. You know, you have credit, debt just going through the roof. You've got interest rates at an all-time high. If you want to try to go buy a car or anything like that, really people are just hunkering down. That's kind of what I'm thinking as far as what's going on. People are not really doing a lot with their money right now and, you know, literally taking it in cash and saying, you know, we're going to sit on this for a while because it just seems to be a continuation of bad news, right? And I think that's fundamentally what you've got going on here. If you look at crypto, it's doing okay. I mean, it's down 1.5. I'm not saying down 1.5 is doing okay. I'm talking about as a relative measure kind of versus everything else that is going on bad in the macro scenario and kind of crypto, or excuse me, in the financial markets in general. I think crypto is holding up fairly well in light of some pretty significant kind of bad news out there that just seems to be pervasive underlying everything. Again, I always talk about this fear, uncertainty, and doubt. The FUD, the fear, uncertainty, and doubt that is out there just in general, kind of in our consciousness, in our everyday, is there front and center, which I think is keeping people away from investing in crypto as well as in stocks. I mean, you see it, you know, stocks, not great times. Now, there's a silver lining here, right? The silver lining is money is made when you invest on the dips. You buy these dips, you buy when things are lower. Do we have room to move down? Yeah, I think that's possible. I think if we continue to see kind of this ongoing narrative of bad and bad and bad about the housing market, the, you know, the car market, the financial markets in general, inflation, Russia, Ukraine, war. I mean, there was a story this morning. Russia launched a missile attack on the Ukrainian capital, right? And it's just this continued ongoing just bad that's out there. I think that's what's causing a lot of crypto prices to move down. Again, crypto is not moving down as bad as it could be moving down. Our low is right around 700 million, give or take. 754, I think, is what it was. And we're 500 million above that. I would love to see us hold the line and stay above that $1 trillion market capitalization. And I'm talking about this number right here. I'm talking about this number right here, the market capitalization above that $1 trillion, you know, mark. That's what I would like to see. But again, I have no power over that per se. So bottom line, those are some reasons I think that everything's moving down. The Dow's down 200% down. You know what I'm talking about. 200. Oh, that's not what I meant. Not 200% down. It is down 219. Whew, down 200% would be not good. It's been a long day already. Money's made when you step in and you buy on the red days. Not investing advice. I'll see you.